Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. Today we're going to look at the circle to land procedure. We're in the Fenix A320, about to turn short final on the RMP for runway 15 at Santorini in Greece. We're going to be breaking off that approach at minimums and flying the circle to land procedure. This is something that as we pick up our summer schedule, certainly in my operator, we do a lot more of. Some of the Greek islands are well known for their circle to land procedures, but why do we fly them? So a lot of the Greek islands and many other airports only have an instrument landing system or an RNAV approach, RMP approach from one side, so obviously that's the preferred choice. It may be limited from the other direction due to terrain. There may be an obstacle in the way restricting an ILS facility being installed. But most of the time that's fine, you know, the prevailing conditions allow us to use the instrument landing system, but there are occasionally times when the winds will vary and we'd have to find a way into the other runway, and the circle to land procedure is one way of getting in. It's not available at all airfields, so we do need to check the charts, and obviously we do need to get ATC clearance to allow us to fly this approach. So let's have a look at the charts. So here we have the RMP for runway 15, Santorini, Greece. We're currently about here, just past Exoti, and we're coming in for RMP runway 15. We're going to break off, and here in the bottom right you'll see we have circle to land. We have a minimum gradient to reach there on the climb. We're Cat C, so and the speed we want to be looking at here is 180 knots, it would be nice and slow. So 1,490 feet is the minimum, so that's the height we'll fly the circle to land procedure. So what we'll do, we'll continue down on the RMP to 15, and we would push the level off on the FCU, you know, using the vertical speed control, 100 feet before the minimum descent altitude of 1,490 feet, because we need a bit of time for the aircraft to obviously make that change. And then we'd break the approach off. We'd make a left turn today because, as you can see, the circle to land procedure is not authorised to the west of the runway, so we need to fly to the east. So we're turning left by 45 degrees and would fly on that new heading for 45 seconds, and then we'll pick up the downwind course of 154. We'll activate our secondary flight plan at that stage, so we've got that set up for Santorini's runway 33. Once we're beam the runway threshold for runway 33, we'll begin another timer, and that timer is based on 3 seconds for every 100 feet of altitude, so let's base it on 1500 feet, we'll round it up, so we'll fly that timer on that heading or further out for another 45 seconds, and then we'll begin a standard rate descending turn, configure FAPS full, and line up visually at that point for runway 33 from the opposite direction. So it's very much a visual approach. We must maintain visual contact with the airfield while we are flying this approach. So we'll continue on down and we'll enter track FPA mode because we want to be flying track. Once we're beyond the threshold and that timer has elapsed, that 45 seconds, we'll disconnect the autopilot, begin our standard rate turn, descending and configuring visually for runway 33. That sounds like a lot to think about. If we're set up well in advance, we've planned out those angles and those times, it's usually quite a nice approach to fly. So let's unpause the sim and we'll continue on down. Ideally we want to be in a flaps free config with gear down at minimums, and we'll fly the circle to land in that configuration. Once we're making our base turn, we'll select flaps full. One thing we need to do is set up that beam point for threshold of runway 33. I'll just 33. in, and the radio is 064. And then you see the line drawn there. So we're descending towards runway 15. And we fly the circle to land in that configuration until we're on base, at which point we'll go flaps full. The next step is we'll push to level off at 100 feet above our minimum descent altitude of 1,490 feet coming up. And then we'll go track FPA, adjust our course, a track 45 degrees to the left, and start the timer once wings are level. We push to level off. And we track FPA, and we're going now left onto track of 109. Once the wings are level, we'll start the timer. Wings are about level now, so we'll start the timer and we'll fly this track for 45 seconds. If we need to adjust for wind, the calculation for that's on screen. Not really too much of a factor today, it's pretty light. So our next step will be at 45 seconds. We'll track downwind, back onto 154 track, and we'll select the secondary flight plan. There's 45 seconds. So we turn downwind, track 154,
minimum,
and secondary flight plan comes active, gives us a funnel approach, extended center line for runway 33. We clear that chrono because once we're a beam runway 33. And obviously we're maintaining a visual lookout here. One of those approaches on this side will actually be easier for the first officer to fly. We're coming up to the abeam point now. So we'll start the chrono again. We do have a bit of a tailwind. We could actually take four seconds off of this tailwind. 4 knots, so we take a second off for every knot tailwind. And the next step will be at 45 seconds, begin a descending right turn. And we'll pick up the visual for runway 33. So, autopilot comes out. We manage speed. And flaps full. Selecting the inbound runway track as well. And from this point, it's very much a standard visual approach, obviously, with view terrain considerations. Eco memo landing no blue. The landing checklist is complete. Reverse, spoilers, ESO. And you're braking. So there we have it. That is the circle to land procedure. It helps us get into some of those runways which don't have those instrument landing systems. It's quite a useful procedure. It's quite a fun one to do, and I do enjoy doing these in the real world. Something a bit different to flying your standard ILS, which we do very often. So it's always enjoyable to come down to places like the Greek islands, where we've got that better weather. And flying some of those, it makes it a little bit more challenging. It's always nice to do. It's one that takes a bit of practice, so do have a play with that one. Just remember to think ahead and calculate those tracks and those timings. That's really important. Stay ahead of the aircraft, and once you're thinking ahead and everything's planned out, it should go pretty smoothly. Any questions on that, please drop them in chat. Please like and subscribe, and if you found that video useful, please consider buying me a coffee through the Buy Me Coffee link in the video description. Appreciated. Thanks for watching.